So if we have a bunch of IIDs which are x1, x2, x3, up to xn, you can do two things from them. You can get their x bar, which is just going to be I is equal to 1 up to n. And you sum them up, you get an x bar. Or you can also get is a take some of the squared deviations from the mean, and you sum them up when I is equal to 1 and n, and you do one of the sigma square there. So these two things that you have obtained from the IID normal variables, they are also independently distributed. While this one has a normal distribution, this one has the chi square distribution, and they are independent. Now, if we look at this a little bit more closely, the chi square this here, the sum of the squared deviations around the mean, that is sometimes also called as S square, so it's also called as S square upon sigma square, is chi square with n minus 1 degree of freedom. The next is the t distribution. So t distribution is also has a set of linear a set of equation on it, which is x bar minus mu divided by under root of n divided by sigma divided under root xi minus x bar square upon n minus 1. So what you get from here is has called a t distribution with a n minus 1 degree of freedom. T statistic is really used for a small sample out of a large population sample, and that is why the mu here will be representative of the population, while the x bar will be representative of the sample itself. The other formula for calculating the t statistics is x bar minus mu divided by S divided by under root n minus 1, where S is the standard deviation of the sample, and X bar is the sample. This gives the t statistics, which you can then put on the table to calculate the probability of it more than of to calculate its probability of t more than a particular threshold. So that's the method of calculating the t statistic.